Hi, my name's Dr. Lee-Shing Chang, and I'm an associate physician and endocrinologist at Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. In this video, we'll be talking about GLP-1 receptor agonists and their use in weight loss. Key takeaway points from this video are to understand the major trials establishing GLP-1 receptor agonists' efficacy for weight loss. When thinking about weight management, there are 5 medications that have been FDA-approved for long-term weight management as of 2021. Of these agents, orlistat works by decreasing the digestion and absorption of fats at the level of the gastrointestinal tract. The other agents work in large part by regulating appetite at the level of the central nervous system. 2 of them, liraglutide and semaglutide, are GLP-1 receptor agonists. We'll focus on these 2 agents in this video. Of note, there are multiple other GLP-1 receptor agonists that are available for use, all of which are associated with weight loss. However, only 2, liraglutide and semaglutide, have specific FDA indications for long-term weight management. GLP-1 stands for glucagon-like peptide 1. GLP-1 is an incretin hormone produced by the L cells in the intestine in response to food intake. GLP-1 has multiple effects, and GLP-1 receptors are found throughout the body, including in the brain, the gastrointestinal tract, the pancreas, and other organs. GLP-1 has numerous actions. From a weight loss and metabolic perspective, the most relevant actions are that it helps regulate appetite and lower glucose. GLP-1 is thought to act at the hypothalamus, regulating appetite by increasing satiety. GLP-1 also acts on the gut to slow gastrointestinal motility and to increase satiety. And it also acts on the pancreas to upregulate insulin secretion from pancreatic beta cells. Liraglutide and semaglutide share over 90% homology to native GLP-1. Both liraglutide and semaglutide have been modified to reversibly bind to serum albumin in the body. This increases their half-life. Both liraglutide and semaglutide were initially approved as glucose-lowering medications for use in type 2 diabetes. However, both have been found to induce significant weight loss in many individuals. Dedicated trials in individuals with overweight and obesity without type 2 diabetes have confirmed their efficacy for weight loss in non-diabetic populations. The SCALE trial established liraglutide's efficacy in weight management. It was a double-blind, randomized controlled trial comparing liraglutide at a dose of 3.0 milligrams given subcutaneously once a day to placebo in just over 3,700 patients without type 2 diabetes and with a BMI either of at least 30 or of at least 27 with concurrent dyslipidemia or hypertension. Both groups also receive lifestyle modification counseling. After 56 weeks, patients in the liraglutide group lost a mean of 8.0% or 8.4 kilograms of their body weight compared to 2.6% or 2.8 kilograms in the placebo group. The STEP trials are a series of trials to study semaglutide's efficacy in weight management. Step 1 was a double-blind randomized controlled trial comparing semaglutide 2.4 milligrams once weekly, given subcutaneously, to placebo. It enrolled just under 2,000 patients without type 2 diabetes, and similarly with a BMI of at least 30 or of at least 27 with at least one weight-related coexisting condition. Both groups received lifestyle intervention. After 68 weeks, patients in the semaglutide group lost a mean of 14.9% of their body weight, compared to 2.4% in the placebo group, for an estimated treatment difference of 12.4%. More participants in the semaglutide group than in the placebo group achieved weight reductions of 5%, 10%, and 15% or more at week 68. For example, for weight reductions of at least 5%, the comparison was 86% in the semaglutide group versus 32% in the placebo group. And 51% of participants in the semaglutide group lost 15% or more weight compared to only 5% in the placebo group. The takeaway point being, significant weight reduction was seen with use of semaglutide once weekly. If you're wondering whether liraglutide or semaglutide is more effective for weight loss, the STEP 8 trial helped to answer that question. The STEP 8 trial randomized 338 participants to semaglutide with matching placebo or liraglutide with matching placebo. Participants did not have diabetes and had a BMI of at least 30 or of at least 27 with at least one weight-related coexisting condition. After 68 weeks, the primary outcome showed significantly greater weight loss with semaglutide compared to liraglutide. The mean weight change from baseline was 15.8% with semaglutide versus 6.4% with liraglutide for a treatment difference of 9.4%. An important note is that continued use of GLP-1 receptor agonists is needed to support maintenance of weight loss. In the STEP 4 trial, after semaglutide run-in period of 20 weeks, participants were randomized to either switch to placebo or to continue semaglutide. As you can see here, those who switched to placebo saw a regain in weight compared to those who continued semaglutide, who continued to lose weight with continuing semaglutide. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this topic helpful.